25 cents, you could buy a pack of bubble gum from a vending machine. For 24 cents, you could feed a starving child. But for a quick visit to CrowderShop.com, you can give a better life.
Brandon, you look good.
To our motion graphics designer, Brandon.
Still valuable.
Brandon needs your help. He's never lived on his own before and is having trouble adapting.
I miss him, though. I've been out for like 3 weeks.
It's like welded to the thing. Like, I can't get it out now.
By visiting CrowderShop.com, you can help give Brandon microwavable meals.
She smells like oatmeal. I'm not even joking.
Electricity. And clean ice cubes.
That's too cold right away. I left my keys in the door twice this week.
Because brilliant motion graphic designers,
I literally have one noodle left,
who may also be slightly on the spectrum, deserve a better life.
I don't know how this works. Okay, I just got it out, so I guess it's fine. But last time it welded it.
Even Brendan, a pedophile.
It's hot.
Oh,
again? Very hot. I don't know if you guys can see the steam. No. I nuked the tea.
Oh, well, you did it to yourself.
Yeah. Speaking of nukes, we'll be talking about Taiwan and China later.
That's perfect.
And Japan.
Mm. Ooh.
Nuclear weapons.
Yeah.
You know that? Yeah. We have a lot to talk. Look, we have a lot to talk. Before I introduce everyone today, I know. Look, I get that most of you say, "Why do I care about Taiwan and Japan? And it doesn't affect us and China." Actually, it really does. And this is something that is, we are on the potential verge of a World War III scenario with, if you look at how tensions have escalated, and if you look at the rhetoric from China and Taiwan and understand the United States history with Japan, look, here's the thing. Non-interventionism is not going to be an option long-term should China decide to march. And I'm a non-interventionist. This isn't a bunch of people fighting over sand dunes that doesn't affect us, that we don't care about. We're not dealing with Tuscan Raiders. We are dealing with people who could have all of the world's IP, semiconductors, electronic technology in their hands and really could involve the entire European Union. It's a scary thing. It's a scary thing. Yeah. So I'm going to try and make it so that your eyes don't glaze over because there are a bunch of other interesting history lessons on Taiwan and China. I'm not going to get through that. Basically, you need to know that China is, in fact, asshole.
Don't trust China. China is asshole.
That man deserves a Pulitzer and a Nobel Prize.
He does.
He's a hero.
If CNN can get some stuff, he needs some hardware.
Yeah, let's just take it from Desmond Tutu.
Yeah.
Just ship it to him.
He doesn't need it.
No, just ship it to him.
Okay, well. Yeah.
That's what we'll do. What do you do after you box it? You ship it, smartass. Okay, so we'll be talking about that. We'll be talking about Fauci. We'll be talking about the Facebook whistleblower.
That's
Beware
right.
the Trojan horse. Mm. But first, Gerald A., how are you?
I am well. I think she's a plant.
Like a ficus? Or
is that a Harvey Weinstein reference?
No.
A fern?
Oh, you mean like controlled opposition.
I don't know. Maybe. I mean, it just seems a little.
She's making the frogs gay.
Definitely doing that.
Yes.
We have Quarter Black Garrett. How are you?
What's up? Good morning.
I don't like it, and you have the whitest hair on earth, so we will get letters. And he has shows coming up here at the Tampa Improv on October 22nd through the 23rd, Orlando Improv. It's like a Florida tour, 15th through 16th. Dave Landau, how are you?
Good. Yes, I'm great. Rocking. I want to thank a fan for making this shirt, because it's dope.
That is awesome.
Is that Full House?
That is Full House throwing up the Wu-Tang.
Wow.
Yeah.
And I love that is just a litany of copyright infringement.
Isn't it? And the other day, you know what we missed? When we should have done Wu-Tang Clams Ain't Nothing to Shuck With.
Oh, gosh.
For two days, I've been rapping that just around my house.
These are the things that keep us up at night.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Missed opportunities. I'm like, World War III, and we missed Wu-Tang Clams.
We missed the shucking joke. It's a genre.
That's awesome.
So I do have a couple of questions for you today. The first one is, how much do you know about China and Taiwan? You can comment below. Let me know how much you know before this show, and if you feel like you learned something after the show. We're going to have a lot of references available today because I want you to be able to do a deep dive into the history. We don't have the time to do all of it.
Right.
I'm going to talk more about why it matters now and how it affects all of us. But first, speaking of someone who affects all of us, he's touched all of our lives.
Really?
Yeah. Like a French Catholic priest, which is another story we'll talk about.
Yes.
Disney, in collaboration with National Geographic, mm-hmm. which used to just be, you know, it used to be called, well, it'll hold me over until the Sears wish list catalog.
Yeah.
Oh.
It was, I didn't even know I was into this.
Yeah. Well, we weren't. We were like, well, take what we can get. Yeah. Okay. Looks like a tube sock with a dinner plate, but good enough for me. I'm
makes
nine.
Me sad.
Oh, my God. Dinner plate?
Slap really a few does. Neck rings yeah. in there. Who's the wiser?
I like a mouth disc.
Yes. who said that? I know there are cultural differences in what people find attractive.
Yes.
Yeah.
But who had a fashion show and someone walked out this beautiful, you know, African woman with wondrous, you know, that creamy smooth skin and bright white teeth, just gorgeous, sun-kissed, and was like, can we make our neck look like a giraffe? Can we do that? Yeah.
Can we invent ear gauges?
Yes.
Yeah.
Can we invent ear gauges? I wanted to look like she was yoked to a yak.
Yes.
Otherwise, I won't get... No, unless she has the yak look. Oh, that's ethnocentric. Yeah.
It's like feet binding.
Yeah.
They're like, we're only making size one shoes.
Right.
That's it.
That's it.
That's on their Tinders. Don't even talk to me if you're bigger than size zero.
Yeah.
And the women are like, hey, look, I make small feet for you.
I'm in the 5 foot. From what I've heard from people on Tinder, I would get no dings or whatever you do.
No, in China, you'd be about average.
Well, no, I'd be taller.
Yeah.
I'd be
like Shaq over there.
To be honest, superhero.
Seeking man who likes woman with plantar fasciitis.
Ooh, you're welcome with the rimp.
My arch can never have enough support because I have no arches. So,
jeez. Culture.
No, it's not.
Disney.
It's not
in collaboration with National Geographic, just they're releasing. We're going to react to this. They're releasing a documentary.
Oh, okay, good.
Some would say propaganda. By some, I mean I. Praising
everybody.
Tony Fauci. Here's the teaser.
Oh boy.
When I think about my dad growing up, I certainly think about that seriousness.
He fathered children.
But wow. Very few people get to see. He's funny, weird, and really playful.
Oh, we got weird.
God help us.
You mean
in 1981, HIV/AIDS was evolving rapidly and
airborne.
Frighteningly.
Yeah, you said it was airborne.
Anger at the government's response.
They were angry that you said they could get it from a cereal box.
Fast.
It's affecting you now.
Yeah.
I got it off a toilet seat.
Post-traumatic stress syndrome.
From what? Being a lying
when
pussy?
COVID hit, he became this target.
My dad said, we're going to get through this whole thing. And he's held that.
You don't do it because you want to make money. You don't do it for the glory. You do it because you care.
When you're involved in a race to stop a horrible disease, you always feel you're not doing things quickly enough.
Dave, are you... Okay. All right, Dave. Oh. Yeah, well, look. We shouldn't have fed him the Wu-Tang clams.
Just glad we still have the
Dave,
bucket.
Dave, you okay,
there.
Buddy?
Yeah. There's a lot in there.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Did you see his daughter?
Yeah, okay. All right. Look.
Hey.
By the way, I love how they say he's not doing it for the glory or money, only he just so happens to get both of those things.
Yeah.
That's how he's paid. He has more money than any other non-elected official in the United States government, and of course, he's never met a camera he didn't like.
Oh.
I'm sorry, Dave. Let's just not lead with anything from Nat Geo in the future.
Or about
yeah, it's
Fauci,
probably
maybe.
Or about
Fauci. Somebody get me an old Nat Geo to settle my stomach.
I need the classic.
Can you bring up just a still image of, just pause it on that last, because he was talking about AIDS, right?
Yeah.
And then he's standing in what looks like a World War II cemetery.
Oh, no, they were putting out flags for somebody, like all the deaths.
From AIDS?
I'm not sure. Maybe it's all the people that he's that,
come on, that's
to.
Obviously a trick of the eye.
Right.
It's like, what, you want us to believe that all of the people who were having, pardon me if you have children in the room, I warn you that they shouldn't be here in 3, 2, people having unprotected anal sex with strangers in truck stops and dirty needles will fill Flanders Field, in Flanders Field where sprites grow?
I think that's why they put white flags, because they were like, hey, we give up your immune system.
Yes.
It's a symbol.
It works both ways.
They are really deifying this guy.
Yeah, they are.
Yes. Did you see that? Like, I love the background music. Always pay attention to that. Like, it's this building, like, to crescendo, and it's like just making him out to be this superhero that's going off to battle against all these dark forces. I'm like, no, you're the dark force that we're battling against. What are you talking about?
He's been wrong about everything.
The white flags actually represent COVID deaths.
Oh, so same joke.
Tie it in.
Yeah, so same joke.
Not that that's funny at all.
It still plays, right?
No, deaths are funny. Just the fact that he went through the effort of putting white flags into a memorial to trees. Like,
I don't think he put all of them.
No.
I mean, that'd take up a lot of time.
Come on.
No, those are the yard workers.
Yeah.
Well, why? He's busy not figuring anything out?
Yes.
Hey, guys, hold on. Is there a camera? I'll put one flag.
He's busy saying everything so that he's technically never wrong.
Right. Yeah. It's like, well, there's no worry about finding a cure. I've been putting out flags for the last 11 years.
But did you see my lawn?
Yeah. Do you like it?
I wish this guy could actually be under oath. Did you or did you not say that AIDS was airborne and that children could catch it being in the same breakfast nook as their parents?
I did,
but then after spending time in the bathhouses, I realized that it changed, and it took me in a history search through anal bleaching. I thought people were walking around with Tooka Slim Shadys. Turns out it's skin pigment.
I thought it was Frank and Berries, not Frank and Berry.
I don't know.
I thought they were having penis for breakfast.
But I am quite fond of it Halloween when it becomes Boo Berry Crunch. Oh. You heard my daughter say it was funny.
I'm good at making ghosts.
Yes. Gosh, this is just, look, this is a man who's, this just goes to show you, when they pick a savior, they pick someone who they want to make a date. They're gonna bite down on their mouthpiece and keep swinging for the fences. This guy's been wrong about everything.
Yeah.
And the only reason that they're picking this guy is because they needed an anti-Trump. They needed somebody as the savior, who, by the way, as a doctor said, well, I couldn't quite say what I wanted to say because Donald Trump was heavy-handed. I'm like, I thought as a doctor you were supposed to just tell us the truth, period.
That was like your
job. It doesn't matter if you get fired. If you get fired, that's what you're supposed to do to make sure you protect the American people, which is what they're saying you did.
But that being said, I mean, look, we never saw Fauci while Trump was president.
That's like Michael J. Fox's doctor being like, I can't tell him this.
Right.
He's a star.
He is.
Let's just tell him he's...
You've just got a nervous tick. It's happy anxiety.
Yeah, you're a nervous guy.
Yeah, you know, look, sometimes there are remnant effects from earthquakes.
Come on. I don't want to tell Alan Thicke he's, you know... Got something. Why did he die? No,
it's just a hard
Could have been an auto wreck.
Yeah, it's just a difficult conversation. Yeah. So doctors, hey, but you know what? That might be different if he had seen a patient in 40 years, doctor. All right, you can check out, Gerald has his shirt. You can get it at Crowder Shop.
Yeah.
Crowdershop.com.
For today, right?
And the best way to tune in, look, is I just ask you, hit the notification bell. Mm-hmm. Well, if you're watching, because subscriptions don't really mean a whole lot. So hit that notification bell. And the easiest thing is, look, it's a live show Monday through Thursday at 10 a.m. Eastern. We go an extra hour on Mug Club. We'll take your chat a little bit. Okay.
We will.
So this is another story that we have to, a new report published by the Independent Commission on Sexual Abuse. Found that the Roman Catholic clergy in France have sexually abused 216,000 minors since 1950.
I got to be honest, 216,000 seems kind of light for the French. I bet a lot haven't come forward because they're mimes.
Well, you know what? You make a good point. I mean, they basically have red wine in their Lunchables. As priests, it's a layup. What have you been doing?
Oh, my God.
That's true. I actually went to Catholic school, and I never realized it the whole time. I was just dodging dicks like tackling dummies.
Did you dodge, them all?
Huh?
Did you dodge them all?
No.
You're out of here!
What? I got fired for being touched.
And I know that there are... I know there. Look, of course, there are a lot of great Catholics out there who are watching this. Our problem is with the clergy. Our problem is with the higher ups. There, this is something that absolutely should not happen. You think you get to like 1,000 kids?
Yeah.
You say something's going on here.
Right.
You think you get to 50,000? Maybe you stop talk. You know, you stop talking in Latin. You go, hey, wait, hold on a second. This seems like it's getting out of control. 200,000. At what point do you do something?
Right, and it's a global problem. I'm sorry, Michael Voris, but we're not exactly buying that the church was infiltrated by some rogue priests when it happens on almost every continent. I'm leaving out Antarctica.
To be fair, the last 150 were breakthrough gropings.
That's true, yes.
Incredibly rare.
They did come up with a vaccine for it, just not everybody's had their dosage. Right?
And instead of bread and wine, somebody just got the butter.
Yes. One of my favorite
anybody
jokes.
Got that last Tango in Paris joke?
I appreciate it. My favorite joke from Dennis Miller is he's saying, I went to confessional the other day. I said, you first.
Yeah, I love that. as somebody raised Catholic, I do not dislike Catholics. Whenever I make those jokes on stage, I say God's on my side of the joke because I believe he is.
Yes, of course.
He hates pedophiles.
Maybe not Fauci's God.
Well, I don't know who Fauci prays to.
Yeah. You mean himself?
Yeah, himself.
Not any God you pray to.
Yeah, definitely. That's the thing when people are like, oh, all paths lead to... No, they don't. No, they don't. They do not all lead to the same place. That's why I follow the Jesus God, Judeo-Christian God, or as I call him, good guy God.
He looks like Jim Henson threw him in a trash can.
Yes.
I don't know who he's praying to.
And then he was washed on a steam cycle. Okay. So my question to you is now at this point, I got a new dryer. It has a steam cycle. It's very nice.
It's weirdly accurate.
I'll never iron again.
Nope.
Praise be to me. So I want to know if you people have been following the whistleblower scenario here. Mm. We said beware the Trojan horse.
Yes.
And there was information that was circulating, but we weren't able to confirm. Sort of like we'll talk about later, China ordering a huge amount of are they CRP tests?
PCR.
PCR tests. CRP is C-reactive protein. I get the acronyms mixed up.
That's okay.
PCR tests back in mid-early 2019. I just didn't want to talk about it yesterday until I knew it was right. That's why it's important that you call us to the mat on this. All the references are available at letterwithcredit.com. So we suspected this yesterday.
Yeah.
And we had to confirm, do our due diligence. But a lot of leftist ties with this whistleblower now. And I want to know if you guys knew about that and how early you knew about that. Frances Haugen, I want to make sure I get her name
Wagen.
Right. Wagen?
No, it was just...
Is that how it's pronounced?
I was agreeing with you.
Oh, not to be confused with Frances McDormand.
I didn't mean to throw you off. I don't know.
I thought it was spelled H-O-G.
I have
weird. Hey, really quickly, this kind of hits a story we're going to get to in just a second on CNN. Right?
Oh, wow, they're talking about Taiwan right now.
China capable of launching full-scale invasion by 2025. Or, sorry, China capable of launching that invasion.
Now, CNN,
they
like,
can do it way earlier than 2025. Yeah. CNN is like, nothing to see. All is well.
Yeah.
It's not. It is not well at all, just to be clear. If something goes down, it's going to... Hey, why do you think they picked 2025?
I don't know. Interesting.
It's after this term?
Oh,
why do you think Joe Biden decided to increase taxes? Like, hey, which class should we increase taxes? The 0.01%? The 1%? What's the percent of people who make more than $400,000 a year? My exact salary cap. That's a 0.124. Yeah, let's go with that.
Random.
Yeah. They're capable by 2015. So you should know how to vote. Hey, we're going to tax everyone over $400,000, which just happens to be what Joe Biden makes. It is just amazing. It's very clear what they are doing. They can do this a lot earlier. I pray to God they don't. Good guy God, not Fauci God. Now, yes. Frances Haugen, she testified before Congress yesterday. Here's the thing. Strongly advocating for increased government control over Facebook. So we were live while it was going on, and some things you may have missed from Ted Cruz, but here you go. Here's her talking about how we need more government.
The severity of this crisis demands that we break out of our previous regulatory frames. Facebook wants to trick you into thinking that privacy protections or changes to Section 230 alone will be sufficient. While important, these will not get to the core of the issue, which is that no one truly understands the destructive choices made by Facebook, except Facebook. A company with such frightening influence over so many people, over their deepest thoughts, feelings, and behavior, needs real oversight. But Facebook's closed design means it has no real oversight.
Well, look, that's not necessarily wrong. And by the way, she does look absolutely strikingly like the Predator. There's no doubt. Come on.
Yeah, I mean, that really
it's
is.
It's uncanny. Now, look, she's
that's
not
unfortunate.
A, she's not a. She's a. Good, she's a good-looking gal. She just looks like
no,
a Predator.
No, she's like
it's
a,
all in the forehead.
Yeah, like she's a doable Predator.
Yeah, well, yeah, she's a dateable Predator.
Yeah, dateable. That's what I
a
meant.
A dateable Predator.
We want to be Christian about it.
Yes.
Dave, that's the line, really?
She's a good-looking really? Woman.
Aliens.
She just looks line. Like the Predator.
She's a good-looking forest alien.
Yes. So, what exactly makes her a whistleblower? Well, we have this. She filed for whistleblower protection status under the SEC.
Okay.
But let's be clear here. There are a few things that you need to know. She's no. She absolutely has a bias. And here's my issue. I've always said when people say, why don't you go after Rachel Maddow or people like that on MSNBC? Why? Because I don't care if someone is biased and they're open about it.
Right. Right.
Mm-hmm. My issue is when Chris Cuomo wants us to believe that he's a journalist. That's what bothers me.
And can dunk.
Right. I can dunk. Yeah. His little 8-foot rim. Why would he argue about that?
I don't know.
Because he's a compulsive liar who grabs women's asses in front of their husband.
True.
He's a piece of human garbage, Chris Cuomo. And he dodged our fight for charity.
Oh.
He can dunk on a butt.
Yeah, that's exactly what he can do. And somehow didn't miraculously never got his ass kicked by a husband.
Yeah, that is crazy.
If someone grabbed my wife's rear end in front of me, if it happened to be you, Jerry,
I know.
I'd be like, well, there's nothing I can do.
You forced
what
it
if it
yourself.
Wasn't in front of you?
Oh, if it wasn't in front of me and it was absolutely confirmed by my wife. Yeah. Like, it's not if my wife said she made him up, he made her uncomfortable. If she said he came up, cupped, went around and squeezed my buttocks, yeah, I would
still have
ding
to,
dong, yeah. Hello, punch in the
bing,
face.
Bow.
That'd yeah. be a talking to.
Yeah.
I'd be flattered.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, she should call me at the party so I can come in, escort him from the party, beat his ass in an alleyway, and then go back in and make sure that everybody knows the reason that your shindig has been disrupted is because Chris Cuomo likes to grab women's asses and then claim it's because he's Italian. Any other Italians here grab my wife's ass? I didn't think so. I'll be eating the shrimp.
I would call my brother and tell him to murder 11 old people.
Yes. Well, look, it's these are the. Do you see what you did, Chris?
You see?
Well, I'm just saying, on top of the many others, that in my own brother, of course, not the governor who would have never murdered
a former governor.
Back to the Predator whistleblower.
Former governor.
Before Facebook, she was a director of data product at Gigster, where she raised concerns that the AI's objectivity might be not transparent, that it might be racist.
It's the best photo of her.
Yes. But you remember how people complained that emojis were racist? Remember how people complained that face recognition software was racist? And we just said, come on now. She was one of those people. So the people who you say are not mainstream, far-left social justice warriors who say that everything is racist, this is what she has done her whole life. Again, beware the Trojan horse. Bill Burton, an Obama-era deputy press secretary, he's actually consulting with her legal communications team, just to be clear. So the direct tie, this is an overlay D with the communications team. And here's something else that people are missing. And I've always said this, it's not just what people cover, it's what they choose not to cover.
Yeah.
So I said this before, and I said again, for example, about the Delta variant. This is entirely conjecture.
Okay.
This is entirely just an opinion. Cannot make a medical claim. I bet you, considering the nature of viruses, how they mutate, we will find out in the future that the Delta variant is significantly more transmissible and likely less lethal. That's probably what we will find out. Why? Because the media is talking about how much more transmissible it is, how much more contagious it is. You don't hear the media saying that it's more deadly. It's what they choose not to cover. That's really important with the Facebook whistleblower. She's saying we need transparency at Facebook. And what does that mean? More government intervention. She was there when the Hunter Biden laptop story got censored. She was there, and her team would have had to have been instrumental in Facebook blocking the Hunter Biden laptop story.
That we learned was absolutely truthful.
She didn't talk about it. The media is not talking about it.
No.
The media is talking about, conservative hate speech and teen suicide. Hold on a second. That was a huge story, which likely would have affected the outcome of the votes of the election.
At least for some people.
I didn't say the outcome of the election. Not about affected the actual the votes.
Some people would have changed their votes. They said that in polls afterwards.
Yes.
Maybe not turning the.
Some people would have attempted. Over. Some people would have attempted to change their votes.
Yes. I hate this.
And the testimony. We'll talk about it on Mug Club. The testimony was entirely about teenage suicide. It was things to pull on your heartstrings. And look, that is a problem, just to be clear.
Right, they were talking about girls, right, committing suicide.
Well, this is also the problem.
Oh, never mind, not a problem.
They were talking about teenage girls committing suicide, and yeah. I understand, of course, I have a daughter now.
Yeah.
Everyone, we do not want to see a company disregarding if they disregarding their involvement in an increase in suicide.
Right.
But why talk about girls? Here's something people don't know. Boys commit suicide at four times the rate of girls, wow. and there is, wow. that very same data reflects that there's an increase in young male suicide. Why does that not matter? By the way, how do you think young males are going to react? When it's just, well, yeah, you commit suicide already at four times the rate, but that's not really pandemic status. And yeah, you know what? The exact argument we're making, that this is increasing teen suicide with girls. You know, let's just talk about girls committing suicide and conservative hate speech. You are going to have young the pendulum's going to swing the other way.
Yeah.
They're going to feel isolated. They're going to feel, you know what people have to do when they don't feel heard? They have to scream. They have to become violent. We don't want that.
No, absolutely not. And honestly, the reason that they're talking about girls is because, frankly, it pulls on the heartstrings more to say girls are committing suicide because of all the images that they're seeing that they can't live up to. And Twitter and, Instagram and Facebook are just pushing those things.
And it is part of the predator feminist agenda.
Well, and I read somewhere that isolation is good for people who are suicidal.
Yes.
Ah, yeah. So 2020
was in No Magazine.
Yeah, it was a win.
It's the predator feminist
agenda. No, I have suicide in my family, so very close to me. So
I apologize.
Well, it was mainly your fault.
Way to be a downer, Dave. Go back to talking about being groped as an altar boy.
Well, right, listen.
Actually, he was the one that was passed over.
The one that passed over.
I wasn't groped.
He was like the kid at a Christmas pageant who just starts singing louder to beat the other kids.
Yeah.
Like, oh, holy infant! So what the hell? What do I have to do? I'm on my low-cut poncho.
I always would spill the wine on myself and be like, I better go change out of these clothes.
Oopsie.
Did you see my spread in Nat Geo?
Yeah. Not a priest one touched him.
So CNN, by the way.
Fred and Nat Geo.
CNN cut away during this.
I have giant nipples. Really?
Ted Cruz, too. This is something they didn't cover in the media. I'm sure they went back to the COVID death ticker.
Yeah.
Cut away during Ted Cruz's questioning. So here's something, again, it's what the media doesn't talk about, that you missed.
Do you know if Facebook, any of the research it conducted, attempted to quantify how many teenage girls may have taken their lives because of Facebook's products?
I am not aware of that research.
Nope, that's wrong. Facebook has known anti-suicide algorithms, and they have reporting on this. In other words, if this was important to her, she would have those numbers. Yeah. Also, if you don't have those numbers, how do you say there's an X time, an X multiple, or X percent increase in suicides?
Yeah.
I don't have those numbers. You know that you're in front of a senator. Like, come, when, if you're not going to prepare.
You know they likely get these questions in advance, you're right?
Here. It's the only reason you're here.
Well, it's the linchpin of your argument. You're basically saying that Facebook knows, then you're like, hey, have they done any research on this so that you can prove that they know? I don't know about that.
What are you blowing the whistle on? Yeah. I guess nothing.
I don't have the data on that.
I don't know.
I assume they know.
I thought... You mean you don't know, Ted?
You had the information.
Who I was told, how are we going to do this? Is this the Abbott and Costello?
Ted, I was hoping you would read the number and I would go, that sounds about right.
Yes. Or in my native tongue, go... By the way, I can't really see you. You're just sort of a red orb. So,
you might have a fever.
They just have her going up to foreheads. You're fine. So,
can somebody please put the little cannon on her shoulder?
I want to see. Little lasers start forming on Ted Cruz.
Just Elizabeth Warren shows up. So, this is something, too. They didn't talk about whitelisting. And this is, again, we've had other whistleblowers. This is where Facebook allows popular leftist accounts, right, to just flagrantly disregard the rules.
Yeah. Yep.
While, of course, they hold other accounts to the closest scrutiny or make up new rules, like with Donald Trump. We've had this on our Facebook page. We've talked about this. The Facebook page was throttled. It's considered misinformation or, potentially damaging information, I believe, even though the information was not incorrect. It was quoting the CDC. The very same thing, by the way, has happened with YouTube. While we're talking about speaking before, a Senate hearing, I think we have a clip of Ted Cruz talking about that. Why wasn't this being discussed from a whistleblower?
And I recount that because the YouTube CEO sat in my office and she admitted Steven Crowder didn't violate any YouTube policies whatsoever. He was entirely consistent with their terms of service. But they nonetheless demonetized him anyway, simply shut off his ability to earn any revenue. And by the way, this is how the man earns his living. Demonetize. I ask everyone here to think how they would feel if some massive corporation demonetized you, just zeroed out your bank account. That is an incredible power.
Well, Susan Wojcicki was in his office talking about me?
What?
You have to tell me about this shit.
Come on, Ted. Make a phone call. Over there.
Sorry.
He thought it was awesome. Clint Howard.
Yeah. by the way, lest you forget, our entire 2020 election stream was removed.
Gone.
From Facebook. Gone. No reason still to this day. No reason given. Look, here's the thing. There are a lot of conservatives who have a victim complex and a persecution complex. Every time a tweet gets removed... when they say that we haven't broken any rules, but they create a new rule, which in the industry is known, colloquialism, as the Crowder rule that stings.
See something like Ted Cruz saying that about you, this is just a side thing. Does that blow your mind?
Yeah, well, it really blew my mind when it was Senator Hirono saying, you are allowing the hate speech of Steven Crowder.
Yeah.
I'm like, can someone please throw her out the window?
I think that's still against the law.
It's against it's frowned upon. And I mean it. I don't mean it literally.
So what is the Crowder rule here, right? That he says something truthful that you just happen to
They
not
create
to like.
Another category. They used to have community guideline rules at YouTube and then advertiser-friendly guidelines.
And then Crowder guidelines.
And then they have borderline guidelines.
Yeah. Ah, okay.
And some would argue that the Vox Apocalypse, if you remember that happened. Alphabet stock took a nosedive because it affected not only us as creators. Then they came out and they had to say, well, actually, no rules were really broken. So they created a new set of rules that are entirely arbitrary and allow them to say, there's nothing inaccurate, there's nothing hateful, we're going to consider it borderline and just harm you anyways. Here's a video of Seth Meyers, because no one watches it unless we force you to.
That's more offensive than anything you've ever said.
Yes,
Seth Meyers is autoplayed. But by the way, Facebook took down the largest live stream of the election, right? I think our numbers were just out of this world crazy. And it's like, oh, we can just stop that, right? You made a great point. Even if they put it right back up, you don't get those views back. People
don't
typically come back in. And they did it on the Oscar live stream when we were obviously doing parody.
Yeah.
Right? And it was fair use. They did it. They took it down. Up, we don't get it back. So that's the game they play.
I thought it was because when you called, I was in my basement, and you called us, and I called Gretchen Whitmer a bad name.
Oh, well,
you guys beeped it.
Well,
we're good.
I have no idea. I'm going to have to go back and review.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dave.
So if it was my fault, technically it wasn't your fault.
Nothing.
I was on a different show.
You are filled with nothing but verbal bile and actual bile. By the way, can someone get this bucket? It's starting to
smells.
Yeah, it's starting to smell like Wu-Tang clam chowder.
There's heat off of it.
And this is something else. They didn't talk about Section 230. It. We've been talking about this on this show. Section 230 is a protection that's afforded to Facebook, YouTube, Twitter. What does it mean? It's very simple. Let me say, if you're talking on Verizon or AT&T, even if you're a Nazi talking about how you hate people of different races, which is horrible, it's abhorrent. But the fact is, they don't have the right to remove your cell service or stop your call. That's the same protection afforded to Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, because they're not liable for any comments or any content on that. That's not the same for the New York Times, Washington Post, because these are considered publishers. However, Facebook, when you clearly see they remove a sitting president, or Twitter removing a sitting president, and YouTube, by the way, you think that all happens at once by coincidence? Let's just be real. You don't think there was a meeting somewhere down the line that they remove him all within 24 hours of each other, and you still have the leaders of ISIS and Hamas out there for crying out loud? If we can't find common ground on the fact that people who throw gays off of rooftops are worse than the president of the United States, who gave an award to Boy George, then there's no common ground.
What award was that?
Yeah.
I don't know. He threw him off a roof before he could.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah. Let's see. It's better than having wigs. Think of Santa. Think of Trump.
Here's a golden trophy for vacuum mouth. I don't know if you guys heard Boy George. Homosexual.
Homosexual guy.
These are things we can say on YouTube. They would be incorrect.
Yes.
Right,
I used to get to him confused with George Michael, and then
everyone.
I realized I wasn't getting him confused at all.
Yeah.
You could write the biography, and it would be very, very similar. You just add a couple of cornrows.
Yeah, just take the name out, put his name in.
Yeah.
Yeah, it would both end with, I got a bit of a cough, and I like hiding in bushes.
Yeah, and then Fauci's like, let me get a flag ready for you.
There you go.
Yeah.
Oh, he must have had cereal.
Yeah, he must have had Cinnamon Toast Crunch in the same... He must have been rooming with Greg Louganis.
It's airborne. By the way, this is the same Facebook and Twitter that removed the absolutely true Hunter Biden story that was not Russian disinformation prior to an election. I'm just going to go back to that. I'm going to keep hitting that.
Yep, yep.
Because if you're saying that you're a platform and not a publisher, then you leave that story up and you let people go in and debunk it, right?
Of course.
But that's not what happened.
Yeah, but now we're supposed to believe that all these same people, of course, are being 100% transparent and truthful on issues like COVID, on issues like election integrity, right? These are the same people who allowed a disinformation. They used to say a Russian disinformation campaign about Trump. No, the disinformation campaign was that there was Russian collusion with Donald Trump.
Right.
That was allowed to flourish everywhere. Everywhere. And by the way, was the crux of why we needed to secure our election integrity from Elizabeth Warren, from Bernie Sanders, from Amy Klobuchar. They said these elections are not secure.
Yep.
And it was based upon a lie. The Russian collusion hoax. The Russian remember the term Russian interference? Interference in what? Our elections. And instead, they allow that story to flourish. Before the election, they get rid of the Hunter Biden laptop story, which, by the way, is not just about Hunter Biden, but about his dad and their ties, not only with foreign, but also China, if you actually understand the story. We know it's true. They've acknowledged that it was true. Now, just like our Oscar stream, just like our election stream, you don't get it back. You don't get those votes back. You don't get that truth back when it needed to be out there. And now we're supposed to believe that, of course, they're beyond fault when it comes to discussing the election and COVID now.
Absolutely. And they need more power. They need more power to censor more people like this.
That's exactly what the whistleblower is calling for.
Exactly.
She's calling for more power for these companies to censor points of view. She isn't, I don't want to attribute motive, but if you really care about suicide, how about you talk about the young boys who are committing suicide at four times the rate?
Right, yeah.
You have any idea what it's like for a young boy to log on to Instagram today? You have nothing but ass models that create sexual frustration, and then male models who are yoked out of their mind on Decadron or whatever it is, and you're like, well, gosh, I don't have a chance because I don't look like this guy, and I want that!
I believe it's Decatron.
Is it Decatron?
Oh, yeah.
I wonder how many of them are like gay and trans kids, though. The boys.
A lot of trans. I mean, especially when you see the one that sadly in Michigan said it was 11. Man. But yeah, that was there is a lot of people in that community, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But a lot of people are struggling to find an identity as well these days.
Hey, do you know what else, too? You're not allowed to speak out against transitioning trans children.
Oh.
On Facebook and Instagram. Guess how many of the kids, if they are not putting on puberty blockers, grow out of saying that they're trans, which, by the way, has a 42% attempted suicide rate pre and post transition.
Yeah.
98%, close to 100%, right? They grow out of it. Guess how many grow out of it once you put them on puberty blockers? Zero. So if you want to prevent those suicides, how about allowing people to say, you know what, let's not start transitioning children and conducting this experiment because we know it leads to record levels of suicide, but that's not allowed either. The point is, this isn't about the betterment of society. This isn't about trans kids. This isn't about suicide. When you listen to the testimony, we have the links in the description below. I highly recommend that you watch them. All of the discussion is about consolidating more power to the tech oligarchy. So we need to do away with this myth that we have common ground. We do not. The only common ground that we have is Facebook bad, big tech bad. Everything outside of that is them saying big tech bad because we think they're allowing too much freedom.
Yeah, exactly. The foot in the door is worrying about suicide.
Right.
And the rest of it is hate speech, which is undefined, and violent speech, which, again, is undefined.
Yeah.
I mean, we're dancing around it, but I think it's very possible, you know, that this is a way of silencing conservatives.
Oh. Yeah,
and I said this to Gerald at lunch yesterday, that I thought it was sort of a
You don't have to think about it, dude.
You had lunch yesterday?
We did.
I hadn't eaten yet.
Oh.
You didn't want to go.
You said Mexican food was a bad choice.
I hadn't eaten yet.
No, he said Mexicans.
Oh,
You guys came back with rims and
talk about Luna that way.
All right, so moving on here, talking about big tech interference. By the way, just so you know, there's been Chinese propaganda that's been allowed to propagate.
Yeah.
I don't know if you remember this when one of the foreign ministers or foreign ambassadors for China accused the United States military of creating and weaponizing COVID.
What?
That tweet's still up. So here's something that you may not know. We were all told, of course, that China found out about COVID-19 in like December 2019.
Yeah,
basically,
late
right December. At the end of 2019 were the first discovered cases, and early 2020. And you guys, if you don't remember, you can check the links, but everyone kind of remembers that's when it started becoming a pandemic. You know, you couldn't buy toilet paper. And this is, again, during that time. This is the story you were fed because the Chinese officials made these claims and they were not fact-checked on Facebook. They were not fact-checked on Twitter. They were not fact-checked on YouTube. And they weren't fact-checked by the American media. They denied being responsible for the outbreak or that they knew about it before this time. But don't take my word for it.
Chinese state media released this cartoon lampooning U.S. accusations as inconsistent and ridiculous. A Communist Party newspaper calling Secretary of State Mike Pompeo a liar over this accusation.
There is a significant amount of evidence that this came from that laboratory in Wuhan.
China has taken unprecedented, comprehensive, thorough, and strict measures to control the spread of the coronavirus. According to the World Health Organization, China's measures have greatly protected the interests of people all over the world.
The people should realize that their enemy is the virus, not China. How about both?
I can multitask.
Strengthen international cooperation, fight the pandemic. How about not lying, China? I'm doing this for people listening.
The accusation is that you've not been honest or
open
about what was happening in the early stages of the epidemic in Wuhan.
No, I couldn't accept that. But first of all, let me
say this.
Sounds
like one of the Muppets in the Star Wars prequels.
Our thoughts are with those who lost their loved ones.
I have many vases.
And also those people who are infected with the virus, perhaps including the Prime Minister. The Chinese government has been very open, transparent, and responsible in sharing the information with the world.
You can see he's reading it.
That feels quite untrue.
And you can see the reflection of a guy with a gun pointed at him in his glasses.
All along, China has acted with openness, transparency, and responsibility. We have provided the information to the WHO and relevant countries in a most timely fashion.
All right, okay. By the way, that's not so much a comb-over as it is a shoe polish lacquer. It's more of a veneer finish.
Yeah, really.
But we're supposed to... I'm sorry, we need to respect the Supreme Leader. Here's
it's
the
true.
Thing.
It's now a terrifying news show.
Yes.
It's just the government.
There is evidence from an Australian cybersecurity firm that Chinese authority were well aware of the virus 8 months prior. So May 2019. Wow. How do we know? In May, they spent $10.5 million on PCR in Wuhan by People's Liberation Army Airborne Hospital. They increased their purchasing of PCR tests by a multiple in May. So here's something that I want to go through here because I spoke about this with my wife and my family. And I want to do an intellectual exercise. I want to avoid the appeal to probability fallacy. So what does this tell us? For example, now that we know that they purchased all these PCR tests, I'm gonna. It's not a trick question. What is that? What do we now know, Dave?
That they knew.
Exactly. Yeah. Good. So, exactly. We know that there was a virus there, at the very least.
Well, even before December, we knew there was a virus there because there were videos of people falling over and stuff like that. You know, so there's...
I cannot confirm nor deny. Well, by the way, I have good urn for you.
Yeah, unless a lot of people just started, you know, getting silly.
By the way, he doubles as the Chinese pallbearer, the Chinese undertaker's about to come out. He's not 6'8", he's more like 5'10", but over there it works.
It works.
Yeah. Very sexy.
When you hear his intro music, dong. Hey, I take you under.
Well, all those videos, too, of people being willingly taken from their homes to quarantine centers. I know they were grabbing on the door and screaming for their life, but it was willingly going.
They were being welded into their apartments. So, everyone out there, and I want you to comment below right now so we can watch this in a timeline. And then you'll comment after because I'm going to ask you a series of questions. What does this tell us? It doesn't tell us that they knew about COVID and lied at this point. Okay, let's avoid making that logical leap. This tells us that there was a virus in China in May 2019 that was enough of an epidemic there that they required massive amounts of PCR tests.
Right.
Okay? So, and I need to do this because we need to avoid misinformation on YouTube.
Correct.
But it's a good exercise to take in your daily life. Okay, what else do we know? Now you have to combine the information we know in tandem. We know there was a virus in China that could only be detected through PCR tests. Okay. And it required massive amounts of PCR tests. All right. We know that COVID came from China. I don't want to say that we know it came from a lab or something. We know that COVID came from China. Yep. No one's even arguing against the fact that COVID came from China. Okay, so we know that COVID came from China. We know that China told us we only knew about this in December 2019 or early 2020. We know that they knew before that and deliberately obfuscated and misled, if not lied about it. Begs the question, why would they do that if it's just a natural virus that came from a bat?
Yeah.
You can look at natural viruses in the past that weren't created in the lab. We were warned. Everyone kind of did work together. Oh, my gosh. We got to get rid of this. What's this? The first SARS in the Toronto airport? Weld them in there. Who gives a crap? No one really cares about the Toronto airport. It's not an international hub. Now.
No.
Why? Why the lies? Why the misinformation? That's where you combine what you have.
Yeah. We didn't bomb Africa for AIDS, right? It was like, I came from a monkey and a guy had a monkey, whatever the story was at the time, right? It came from a bat. We're not going to go bomb you because a bat bit somebody and gave them a virus. Like, we're all in this together at that point. But when you constantly go back and say, oh, we've been cooperating with the WHO, and we're like, every answer they gave was the WHO, the WHO, the WHO, transparency. You mean the WHO that we have proven is in bed with you and kind of bows to your wishes and won't even let you recognize Taiwan, which we'll get to later, in the scariest video I have seen yet of somebody just pulling the plug on an interview?
It's more of a curtsy than a bow, stupid American.
Well, that's true. Yeah.
So dumb.
I thought they bowed. I thought it was about that.
We don't fold at the waist. Use your hips.
Oh, geez.
So, we don't need to even show Clippy because people know. People know. The only people who claimed that it didn't start in China were some Chinese officials who said the United States
military. It's already been proven, right?
Of course. Of course, it's been proven. This is the definition of gaslighting, right?
You're not crazy.
They want you to say that you're crazy if you believe that it came from a lab. This doesn't tell us for sure that it came from a lab. It tells us that they knew about it. It tells us that they lied about it. It tells us that it came from China. It doesn't make sense for them to try and cover up something if it's a natural virus from a bat. Couple of good points that you just made. This is, if that were the case, we're all in this together. So can you take down your stupid fruity bumper stickers that live next to your coexist bullshit? We're not in this together if you don't want to hold the creators of the virus accountable. Okay? Yeah. We're not all in this together. If you guys are not saying, hey, hold on a second. The WHO, who, by the way, determines, this all ties together, what is allowed on Facebook, what is allowed on YouTube, what is allowed on Twitter, and refuses to even acknowledge Taiwan's existence. If you don't have a problem with that, we are not all in this together. Period. Lines are drawn. I'm fine. I'm fine being with the guys who say, you know what? I'm not with the people who want to see Taiwan wiped off the face of the map. We're not all in this together. Also, I think I should be able to go to Lowe's.
Why Lowe's?
Sorry.
It's a nice place.
I like Lowe's.
This gets me worked up.
Well, it should get you worked up because doctors were not allowed to present evidence that could have helped the rest of the world simply because they were in Taiwan and the WHO didn't want to hear it because China would get pissed.
And I think that's what bothers me with all of this.
Yeah.
Look, this veiled sort of accusation of racism, okay? If you speak about China, it actually hides something that is probably the most egregious example of bullying that I can think of. And just because to many Americans you can't tell the difference between China and Taiwan and they look similar does not mean that there isn't oppression against a certain group of people. This is bullying, this is intimidation, and the entire elite, the big tech oligarchy and their media patsies are complicit with this. So this has me move on to Taiwan because it ties it directly into COVID. Look. like I said, I'm a let me set this up here.
Yeah.
I'm a non-interventionist, okay? I don't really believe that the United States should be going and fighting wars abroad if it doesn't affect us.
Yeah.
Or if we want to be an empire, take their stuff. Okay? We're the only empire in the world that didn't just conquer people and take their stuff. We asked for land to bury our dead, right? Generally speaking. Look at the base that we have in Japan. We'll talk about that later. Yeah. We have more troops, I believe, stationed there than any other American military base, if I'm not mistaken. Certainly in the top three. I don't want to misspeak and be banned for misinformation. It's almost like it's ancillary to the point. The point is there are a lot of troops there. But why haven't we taken over Japan? Do you have any idea how easy it would be after the nukes? And we'll get to that. Instead, we signed a treaty saying, no more nukes, we'll protect you. That's important because we do not have the option, the United States, as we're talking about China, Taiwan, and there's been a fuse lit because of COVID and because of people not standing up for Taiwan at this point, China's rhetoric has been getting more and more heated, and Taiwan is very concerned. The United States will have to do something. The decision just becomes, do we do it once there's an attack on Taiwan, or do we wait until it moves to Japan? Because China is not going to stop at Taiwan. It's a test case. So, I think actually right here, let me set this up for you. The foreign minister, Joseph Wu, look at the terror on his face here when he's warning the world about Chinese aggression and this isn't covered on the media. I mean, look at his actual face. He's pleading for help.
China has been threatening Taiwan and the threat seems to be more serious than before. In real life world, there's not a black and white situation, but we are very concerned that China is going to launch a war against Taiwan at some point. even though the threat may not be imminent at this point. But there might be some conditions that China may use force against Taiwan. They might launch a crisis externally in order to divert domestic attention. So in the recent power rationing or power outages in China, that is something that we have been observing very carefully, because we are concerned if the domestic discontent or economic slowdown is getting very serious, Taiwan might become a target of this authoritarianism. When there's a crisis, if the Australian government can go along with other major partners of ours and tell China that the invasion, the war is not right, that will be highly appreciated.
Jeez.
Please help.
Yeah.
That being said, he would be a great
haircut.
He would be a great host for Taiwan Bar Rescue.
It's true.
You're spending too much on bottles. Get yourself draft system. You call this a bar? So, to be clear,
do any of those bars make it?
I don't think
they do.
Just comes in and craps on them. Yeah. So between October 1st and 4th, China, they flew a record 150 aircraft in Taiwan's air defense zone.
Yeah,
I'm not going to get nerdy into exactly which aircraft have been flown in. Look, there have always been tensions between Taiwan and China, and a lot of Americans don't really understand it. Let me make it really clear. It's hard to understand because one is the People's Republic of China and one is the what is it? One is, I want to make sure I get the term right.
They're almost the same.
One is, can someone give me, it's like one is the Republic of China, one is the People's Republic of China.
Something like that.
One of them is the Communist Party, the People's Republic of China, the CCP, and one of them believes in more of a sort of right-leaning nationalist state as it relates to Taiwan. At the very least, Taiwan considers themselves, and they had a war, where they see themselves as a self-governed state entity. Yeah. But it's tough to say it's a separate country from China because they actually view themselves as the real China before mainland China was taken over by the Communist Party.
Right.
That's really what
they fled. John Cena said it's not there.
Yeah. He had all the information.
John Cena said that it was a figment of your imagination. That was right. It's the Republic of China versus the People's Republic of China.
There you go.
Well, the People's Front of Judea, the principle is the same. It's hard for Americans to keep track. Taiwan, not communist. China, communist. China says you belong to us. Taiwan says no. That's where they've had tensions for a very, very long time, and China is willing to attack them. Okay. Then there was in 1996, the third Taiwan Strait crisis. Do you guys know about this?
Yep.
This is important because China launched a bunch of missiles, basically warning that the Taiwanese not to vote. They held the first democratically held elections. Doesn't really happen in China, okay? Happens in Taiwan. This is important. So China launched a bunch of missiles just to say, you guys can't have a democratic election. And at that point, Bill Clinton actually sent two carrier battle groups to waters surrounding Taiwan to actually protect them.
Yeah.
Now, that, it, look, Clinton,
good job.
The biggest fan.
Yeah.
Not bad.
That was good.
Man likes his cigars and hamburgers, but I wouldn't, you know, that's not what I dislike about him. That being said, at that point, it was very clear. The United States said, Taiwan is having a democratically held election. You guys can't start launching missiles. And Bill Clinton went in to protect them. That was a show of force. Contrast that with Biden's rhetoric, not including the Hunter laptop story, not including actual financial ties, just Biden's public rhetoric on China while they've been making more threats to Taiwan as these comments are made.
The rise in China is an incredibly positive development for not only China, but the United States and the rest of the world. Rising China is a positive development. It is in our self-interest that China continue to prosper. We want to see China rise.
China's a great nation.
China's a crappy
nation. And we should hope for the continued expansion.
And we should hope for the collapse
China
of the government.
China is not our enemy.
We talk about China.
They are our enemy, the government.
We should be helping.
First off.
Helping them what?
Yeah, helping them. Yeah.
Please explain, Joe. Finish the sentence.
He has to get his ass wiped.
He doesn't know how to finish a sentence.
Yeah, come on.
That's true.
Good Lord. You know how crazy he'll get? He'll be like dog spiders.
What?
What
are you saying?
What the hell's the matter with you guys?
I like dog spiders.
I'm a dog spider man.
My wife's been butt.
My wife's been what?
Juicy neek.
Feel the cottony softness?
Huh? I pantsed my poop.
You know the thing. Listen. You shake Saddam's hand, you're squeezing the Charmin.
Get the Narcan. Hunter's coming for dinner.
Yeah. Also, hide the child pornography. Hunter's coming for dinner. So.
Rudy has your stuff.
Yeah.
The only way Xi Jinping can eclipse...
not his Rudy.
Yeah, not his Rudy.
Not his stupid Rudy.
What the only way... This is important to note is, hey, what's China's goal here?
Yes.
Because Biden is saying this. It's not... Just like when Barack Obama used to say women get paid 77 cents on the dollar and I would get irritated because I'm like, what, does he not have access to Google? Here's the issue here. Does Biden not know what China has been saying this whole time? It's not just about Taiwan. It goes bigger than that. The only way for their current guy... The only way for... Okay, Xi Jinping versus Mao. He wants to. The only way that the current asshole can replace the former asshole is if he achieves the Chinese dream. This is the actual term, and it involves taking back Taiwan. Here is the current asshole saying it himself.
Compatriots on the mainland and Taiwan should join hands to realize the Chinese dream and take responsibility together for national rejuvenation and share the glory of national rejuvenation.
Yeah, Taiwan really wants to share in the glory of how people live in China.
Caused by the weakness and chaos of the Chinese.
They're frustrated to high heaven that they're not knee-deep in shit eating scorpions at the street fair.
We're willing to negotiate sincerely and expend all our efforts in striving for the prospect of peaceful reunification.
Well, that's nice.
We do not promise to renounce the use of force and reserve the right to use all necessary measures.
This is why Fauci is a chi-com. Remember yesterday he was like, we're going to implement measures that'll lock people down and they won't be allowed to do commerce so that hopefully more of them will willingly get the vaccine. See my white flag. We want to do this peacefully at the end of a missile.
That is basically what they said. And look, you can't blame Taiwan for being worried about this because that whole the China dream, they want that to be accomplished by 2049, right? So the clock is ticking on all of this right now. They also see that they have a window of opportunity with a very, very weak president with weak foreign policy.
Yes.
He did it with Russia. They didn't do anything under the Biden administration with Obama when they attacked the Crimea. They also attacked Georgia. They still have 20% of their troops there right now in Georgia, still occupying, nothing being said. And then you pull out of Afghanistan and the rest of the world sees you as a pansy.
Yes.
Right? You don't think that these guys are thinking about that. And by the way, if you think Taiwan thinks that China's going to play nice, Hong Kong was in the same situation as Taiwan where they were allowed to be separate and ruled. Mm. What happened when freedom started to ring?
Yeah, what happened when the Hong Kong protesters... Yeah, not only do the Hong Kong protesters wave American flags and sing the national anthem and beg America for help, but John Cena and LeBron James said that we shouldn't be talking politics.
Right.
Really, yep. Black Lives Matter? Really, when we're talking about vaccines, but people who are being clubbed to death in the streets for wanting a taste of freedom... Nothing to say? Oh, that's right. I forgot. Space Jam is going to be released internationally.
Oh, that's true. Right. Yeah.
And thank goodness.
Yes. Yeah. That's really actually, it's effectively a biochemical weapon.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
That would be the only redeeming quality. Ah, there's no plot line. Like melting like they saw the Ark of the Covenant.
Just a piece of crap.
It didn't need to be remade.
No. No, it wasn't even that old. I hate the fact that we're so uncreative. We just keep making the same movies.
It's like, what do we do?
It's not even a movie from the 30s. You're just making stuff from when I was a teenager.
Yeah.
Just, it's nuts.
I've seen this before.
A lot. And Dumb and Dumber 2. Shame on you.
Yeah. Wait, which one?
Shame.
Dumberer.
Dumb and Dumberer or Dumb and Dumber 2?
Let's go with both of them.
That's right. Yeah, let's go with both of them.
There was a
although Dumb and Dumberer may have been better.
Yeah, I agree.
I won't lie.
If you accept it as a different movie, sort of like Legend of Zelda 2. It's a different game in the franchise. It's not really the same as the rest of them. Or Super Mario Brothers 2, which in Japan, which we'll talk about in a little bit, was actually known as Doki Doki Panic. But Super Mario 2, the lost levels, were actually seen as too difficult for American video gamers because Japanese people think that you're fat, lazy, dumb American
A little correct.
Halloween 3, Season of the Witch.
Yeah, but you know that's what? True. If that were its own film, it would still suck. So
no, I disagree. Good movie.
What was the song for The Mask? Something, something, something.
Halloween 3, Season of the Witch.
That's not it at all. You're just saying the title.
To the same rhythm that he had.
That I had, which was wrong.
That's none of that's correct.
It was I think I was right. You guys look it up.
Season of the Witch.
Oh, a little, little rock in
oh,
there.
Like that.
Did I add it?
Next thing is
Season of the Witch.
Yeah.
The Witch is season.
He's just taking lyrics and put them to Journey. It's just Halloween 3. That's where I want to be. I want to be watching Halloween 3.
Born and raised in Halloween 3.
Don't stop Halloween 3.
I was born in Halloween 3.
I was
once, twice.
What are we doing?
Three times a Halloween.
Yeah. Oh, Zantac.
Oh, it's heart medicine.
Okay. So here's the thing. Should China and Taiwan go to war? And what I mean by that is, should China decide that they're going to do what they've said they're going to do for a very long time? It is pivotal for Taiwan's existence that they enlist the help of the United States Navy. Now, what's really kind of sad is they've been reaching out to Australia for help. Why? Well, they saw what happened with Hong Kong. I don't think they believe that the United States is going to help them that much right now, which is really sad for as it relates to our country. Here's the thing. Something people don't understand. It's concerning that this is going on in October. Why? If China strikes Taiwan, they can only do it 2 months out of the year. October or April. People don't know that.
Yeah.
And let me explain to you why. This is actually from Ian Easton, Pacific defense security expert and author of The Chinese Invasion Threat. He says that April, there's heavy fog, but good suitability. October, there are still high winds and waves later in the month. But all other months, you have typhoons, gales, high winds, waves, and basically no suitability here. I don't know if I can point here on this map so you can see. They got to go across that, which really doesn't look like that much. But it's kind of like when you think you can swim to the other side of the lake after you've had a few Coors Lights.
Yeah.
And then you find yourself like Davy Jones's lock.
Well, look at that. It's a bottleneck, right? So it's actually pushing all of that through that tiny strait.
Right.
So that's why it becomes so hard to pass.
And here's something people don't know. A lot of you think like, oh, we're talking about, you hear numbers from World War II and millions of people dying. Look, wars, when it comes to something like Taiwan that's just separated by a strait, when you're talking about that effectively, these are won by something very specific. You're really talking about carriers. You're talking about aircraft.
You have to have them.
And you can count on your hands and toes how many exist in the world. Now, why does that matter? Because you need to be able to get your aircraft to and from the location, right, in a way where you don't run out of fuel that's safe. So you need to have an aircraft carrier. These things cost like $22 billion. And again, you need to get that across really torrent waters. The United States has 10 Nimitz-class supercarriers and 9 Wasp and American-class carriers. China only has 2. They have 1 in development. Australia has 2. Taiwan has 0. This is it seems like they're pretty outmatched.
It seems like you have 23 or 24 fingers and toes, though, too. This is another problem.
Well, look.
Yeah.
My dad slash uncle.
Yeah. Steven's a flipper, baby, and we just didn't even know it.
Also, I'm an outie, and when I say it, it drags at my feet.
His sister mom is all about it.
Right.
Did they say that it was a Wasp carrier?
It's a kind. So what the Nimitz class supercarriers are nuclear, like they're self sustained.
Oh,
they can go on basically forever. I mean, except they're going to run out of food. But at that point, if they're saying, you're going to have some Chinese military bodies. You just you eat those.
Yeah, but then you get hungry again 30 minutes later.
Like wealthy. Very true.
It's very tasty, though. Very tasty.
Those are his last words.
Oh, it's delicious.
No, I won't be feuding.
I'm all bone.
I'm not one time.
No muscle.
If
it were a Bond line, he would just be like the guy killing him before he's going to be like, I'm a grazer.
May I suggest intermittent fasting?
So, why have they not been reaching?
Shoot it.
Why, this is very different, right? The posture from China under Donald Trump to Biden. I mean, it's like a switch was flipped. Just like North Korea and the rockets, like it's 4th of July.
Right, yeah.
Well, because one's crazy and one may have dementia.
Right.
What do you want? You want a leader that comes off as they're a little nuts.
Right.
You do.
Even to the Chinese.
Yes.
Have you been to Chinatown?
I don't. Well, just the town,
It's like a fever dream.
It certainly is.
Put your stuff in the fridge. So, Victor Gao, he's the VP of the Center for China, professor of Suzhou University. He had this to say about the U.S. defending Taiwan against China. So do they think that maybe we're in a weaker position now? Well, don't take my word for it.
Well, the United States does have an agreement with Taiwan to support it in the event of an attack, to potentially arm or even potentially join in the defense of Taiwan.
The United States has never offered Johnny Melanoma? To defend Taiwan. The United States just want to be the biggest arms dealer with Taiwan, selling them more sophisticated weapons. And in doing that, they are in violation of the three communiques. No government ever since 1971 has ever pledged to fight on behalf of Taiwan, to shed the blood of the American soldiers for China's reunification. No. And I can bet with you, the Americans will not allow their sons and daughters to die for China's reunification. That will be in itself a futile attempt.
Didn't you hear, by the way, at the one point, where, like, he's the only person who, you know, you would use the colloquialism swallowed a frog, but he actually just swallowed a frog. Just did,
yeah. A gay frog.
Yeah. And just swallow actual frog. I told you, I'm making the frogs gay. It's sashaying down his throat. It is destroying his trachea. So
you must swallow it to kill it.
Yes.
It was a French priest.
So look, and he's right. Americans shouldn't die.
That's true.
Right. Americans shouldn't die, of course, because China has some intercontinental, I don't know, feud. Here's the thing. It doesn't stop with Taiwan. Let's be really clear about this. This is why we're on the verge of World War III if something like this happens. Taiwan can only be defended by a sort of a unified European Union, very unlikely, and probably Japan, maybe Australia, or the United States. They would need a coalition of everyone who haven't been able to even agree to pay their share of NATO, by the way,
right?
Or the United States. Otherwise, they cease to exist. If Taiwan ceases to exist, Japan's next, likely Australia. Australia. These are sitting ducks, and that comes to your doorstep. This does become a global affair when you understand that China's goal is to run the world like a Bond villain. So, here's something else. They don't believe, though, Taiwan, that the United States is going to support them. How do you know? They reach to Australia. They look to Japan, right? Yeah. Who have been? They've been increasingly vocal, by the way, for the first time. For the first time in the last 6 years, they never used to even mention Taiwan because it was kind of a sore spot with China.
Yeah.
So when it comes to the economics of it, it's not in their best interest. And now they have been saying and speaking out very vocally, saying we need to be ready to support Taiwan in some kind of a military affair. Japan just bought a record 5.4 trillion yen, so $49 billion, in a defense budget. And here's the thing. They better get their asses in gear because the Muppets over there in China have been saying that they will nuke Japan if they intervene at all. Here you go.
我们在解放台湾时，如果日本胆敢武力干预，哪怕出动一兵一卒、一机一舰作战力量，我们不是对等还击，而是对日本全面开战。
We will use nuclear bombs first. We will use them continually until Japan declares unconditional surrender.
只要日本认识到承受不起战争的代价，就不敢贸然出兵台海。
Now keep in mind that that film was made, granted, on like a version of 98 Movies Maker by the China's Communist Party, and they took it off the Chinese video platform Zigua after it got 2 million views. It's still available. It's still available on YouTube and Twitter.
Wow.
Oh my God.
Wow. How is that not a call to violence?
Yeah. And by the way, I don't know if people know this, but Taiwan was technically a part of Japan for about 50 years, right? It wasn't until after World War II that kind of...
Well, we can get all that stuff in Manchuria.
No. But I mean, these people hate each other. So when you say that Japan is the next step, Japan is the real enemy for China. Like, they are... Right. They're the people that they really want to get even with.
Taiwan's a test case. If you look at how the islands are positioned, they go, okay, Taiwan, boom, 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 hopscotch, Japan, and Japan knows it. That's why the former Japanese Deputy Prime Minister, Taro, so he said, if a major incident happened over Taiwan, it is safe to say it would be related to a situation threatening survival of Japan. And that is the case. If it is the case, I put a frog in my throat. Japan and the U.S. When I eat a frog, he's smiling at me.
Happy gay frog.
Can you do a Japan?
The
Alex
U.S.
Jones?
And Japan must defend Taiwan together.
Just means happy frogs.
No, they have to, and we have an agreement to do that with Taiwan. But if they attack Japan, it's like, come on, guys, you know how many troops we have there? What are you going to just like surgically strike places that don't involve our troops?
Well,
like,
before we even get to Japan, here's the thing: if China takes Taiwan, guess what? They are now in charge of everything technologically.
Yeah,
they have So China's sort of their manufacturing is, I would say, low grade. Like, the truth is, some of their manufacturing is better than stuff manufactured in the United States. But I'm saying it's more like textiles, simple electronics, right? They have some computer chips, but all the semiconductors and a lot of the sort of high-end intellectual property, really, like Samsung, a lot of the stuff is done in Taiwan. Yeah. So if China takes over Taiwan before they even get to Japan, right, this puts them in a tremendous position for war because they would effectively run all of the world's IP, all of the world's computer chips, semiconductors. Right now, because of COVID, I don't think people realize the supply chain disruption. You have brand new trucks that are sitting on lots rusting out because they can't have chips shipped quickly enough.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Cars are insanely high right now.
Oh, absolutely. What do you think happens if China gets control over all of this?
Yeah. It's kind of like the equivalent of OPEC. It's like, oh, you need oil to run your cars? Yeah, we'll have to talk about that. You'll basically bow to what we want. And if they have that, again, like if they have the semiconductors, it's like, it's in everything that we use, guys. It's not like just one or two.
Oh, things. It's unbelievable. Yeah. So it's something that not only do they go on to Japan, but this is something that affects the United States immediately. And then you're looking at the very least an economic war between the United States and China and tariffs. And we would have to retool all of this stuff here in the United States. The point is, it would upend the way the world does business. And no one at CNN, certainly no one at Disney, wants to talk about it. This is way more of a threat than some folks in the Middle East. I just need to make this clear. And by the way, the foreign minister, Joseph Wu, he knows what I'm talking about.
Other than that, Taiwan is a significant bastion for the production of computer chips. And if Taiwan is under attack, I'm sure the world is going to feel the impact.
Okay.
Yeah, a little bit.
Let me cycle through this really quick. China hates Japan, of course, right? They claimed Okinawa. That's not true. It's not China's. Okinawa is only 411 miles away from Taiwan.
Very close.
Then you have the Senkaku Islands that are only 231 miles from China. So again, they're talking about they would hopscotch Taiwan, take all the IP, take all the manufacturing, and then boom, 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 hopscotch a couple of islands in Okinawa, Japan. It's very easy to make, and they would be fools not to make it. They cannot go after Taiwan and then wait for Japan. Because Japan's going to react. So an attack on Taiwan is done with the plan of collecting $200, pass and go, going into Japan. Here's why that also involves the United States. People say, well, we shouldn't get involved anyway. We don't have that option. Because after World War II, we kind of did some shit. We dropped some nukes. I'm pro-nuke in Japan if you understand how many more lives would have been lost in a land war. That being said, this was the kind of thing that decimated parts of Japan. Rather than conquering and taking their stuff, we signed a treaty. It's actually, I want to make sure I get the name right, it's the Mutual Security Treaty between the United States and Japan. What that said is that Japan could not build a military for offensive sources or intervene in conflicts internationally. And as a guarantee, we promised them that if ever they were attacked, we would defend them. In other words, if China decides to move on to Japan, which they would if we don't protect Taiwan, we are obligated internationally to intervene. Non-interventionism is not an option unless you just believe that the United States should tear up all of our agreements. I do think that maybe this is a little bit outdated, that we should just say, hey, look, you know what? It's been 70-something years. You guys have been playing ball. Here's some nuclear technology. Have a field day.
I think that makes a lot of sense. We can help you balance out power there. We trust you guys.
Right.
You're good people.
Certainly more than China.
Well, yes. Guy.
So look, with all of this, and let me, again, I want to see you guys comment below so you let me know if you knew about this and if you understand how concerning it is. And I know it's nerdy, but it's something that, guys, I cannot tell you how important this is.
Yeah.
There does not need to be more than just, if one domino falls, you're looking at a minimum of hundreds. There can't be a one domino effect here. It doesn't stop with one domino. Yeah. And CNN at this exact same time, while we're doing this show, and now apparently they have Princess Zelda who didn't hit the shift key on air. They were saying, maybe by 2025, because they want to absolve Biden of responsibility. Look, what are the chances? What do I think the chances are? This is entirely conjecture. I think the chances of something happening severe between China and Taiwan under Biden's term, I would put that at about 80 or 90%.
Yeah.
At some point before Biden is out of office, I think that China is going to make a move with Taiwan. And I really, really wish that we didn't have to be involved, but if they make a move on Taiwan, it goes on to Japan. And of course, you probably don't want your economy even more decimated than it was here after COVID. And by the way, well, people are going to start commenting and saying, look, I'm not a John Bolton, okay? That guy who sweeps between the Rocky and Bullwinkle
You're
cartoons.
You're a Michael Bolton.
Yes, exactly.
Sorry, I ruined your rant there.
My point here that I'm making is, does anyone really want to argue? Do I need to provide references for anyone to understand? Or if we're going to find common ground, can everyone at least agree that Donald Trump was tougher on China?
Donald Trump, don't trust China. China is asshole.
That guy had it right. All right, we have to get going here the YouTube. You guys can comment. Wait, can we tell him to smash that like button?
Smash the like button. Yeah.
Right there.
Smash that like button like it's Okinawa. All right, YouTube, thank you very much. I'm sorry that we spoke out against your overlords in China. We know you're trying to bust into that market, but you can piss off.